Welcome to the lockdown edition of BIS News for 2021. I'm Matilda.
I'm Kaylee.
I'm Micah.
I'm Jacob.
And I'm Vanessa.
Over the last couple of weeks, we have
changed tech classes,
continued winter tournament training,
had a methics assembly,
and we've begun our whole water topic.
Thank you. story is so true. It's that love you can't deny. I can see it in your eyes. One-on-one is something no one we must do.
No.
Formed a pathway in your brain, it's quite hard to open up the gate of that pathway. Like, as soon as you learn to ride a normal bike fluently, that gate shuts. So then you've got to open that gate up and let some new knowledge in so you can ride it. Simply like that. Well, not simply, but so, turn left and we'll walk right to the fog mesh. All that changes is the steering. Well, it's not easy. So look out in the notices for when we put this out on the court at lunchtime, and if you make the distance of a court without touching the ground, you get a chocolate bar, just plain Cadbury milk chocolate. So look out in the notices and we'll have it at lunchtime and feel free to give it a shot. So
now it is time for the interview.
Last episode we interviewed Mr. Connolly.
This week we will be interviewing Miss Mannix.
She is the teacher of room 8.
Let's see what she has to say.
Okay, thanks Miss Mannix for taking time out of your day, of the lockdown day, to let us interview you.
No problem at all.
So what is your favourite sing-along song?
I have quite a few, but one that comes to mind is Living on a Prayer by Bon Jovi. A bit of a classic and one that gets turned on to the stereo quite loud.
What subject do you enjoy teaching the most?
I really enjoy doing writing with my class. The reason I love writing is that it's really cool to see kids get really positive and you know, they take risks and challenges with words, and using the success criteria and using models, you can actually usually come up with a really cool piece of writing very quickly. So it's something that's quick and easy to do, and I really enjoy working on writing with my students and being able to do it with them. So that's really cool.
How many bars of chocolate would you normally eat in a lockdown day?
I haven't eaten any yet. We've had
really?
Pumpkin. Yes, seriously, we've actually had pumpkin cake in the pantry, and so we've finished that, and the teachers will definitely know what that's all about, because I've made a few for staff. But no, I haven't eaten any chocolate yet, but I'm gonna have to do a supermarket dash this afternoon, so I might have to sneak a couple into my trolley.
May I ask, is that a new record?
It probably is. You guys think I eat it all the time. I'm a bit concerned why that is.
Yeah.
What's your favourite destination?
Locally, it would have to be Okiwi Bay, because it's somewhere that's really close by, but you feel like you're a world away, and it's just so beautiful there out in the water. In New Zealand, probably the Catlins. I lived there for a few years when I was a kid, and it's just so beautiful, rugged coastline, gorgeous beaches, lots of wildlife. Internationally, Probably Thailand. Man, it would be nice to be able to travel internationally, wouldn't it? Yeah, I lived there for 2 years and that was just a stunning place. Lots of beautiful islands and cool big cities and really cool vibe. So fingers crossed we'll be able to travel sometime in the not so distant future.
What is your favourite thing about BIS and why?
The students and the staff. The staff are amazing and incredibly supportive, and they work so, so hard to provide lots of opportunities for the students. The students, because they're such a diverse and amazing mix with so many incredible talents, and every day is an adventure. You know, the police say, you know, get better work stories. I think teaching probably could be along that line too, because no day is the same and it's always exciting and new and fresh and sometimes frustrating. But yeah, most days are amazing and you come home feeling exhausted, but knowing that you've done something pretty cool.
Thank you for letting us interview Miss Mannix.
You are welcome. Luckily, I was out of bed.
Have thought about what we would like to leave for Broad Green and the students of the future.
This led us to the collective decision that a greenhouse would greatly benefit our school.
Imagine this as a greenhouse.
A greenhouse supplies a continuous amount of fruits and out-of-season vegetables,
such as tomatoes, for your food technology projects.
We'll provide seedlings for trees and other plants that could be used to beautify the school.
Teachers might find a greenhouse useful by using it as a hands-on learning experience for their students.
A greenhouse goes a step further to creating a green image for the school.
And this is where we want it to go.
Greenhouse, assemble!
Broad Green, live in the greenhouse!
Greenhouse!
We said greenhouse!
Last week, we did our star presentation.
On being a star in Term 3.
This week, our star presentation
is on how to be a star in lockdown.
It's important that we look after ourselves in our final in lockdown. This is what it means to be a star in lockdown.
Exercise and get outside.
Get funniest love from everyone we meet.
Try not to annoy siblings in lockdown.
Social distance, 2 meters apart.
When out and about, remember to social distance. You need to be at least 2 meters apart from anyone who is not in your bubble. That's about this far.
Face your mask or covering going to the supermarket.
Good job! Yeah! Take care of hygiene and keep hands clean and sanitized.
Thank you.
That is what it means to be a star during
lockdown.
Now it is time for this week's Myth Challenge. Thank you for watching the lockdown episode of This News.
We hope you enjoyed our show.
Please make sure to like, subscribe, and smash that bell.
Good luck to everyone in lockdown.
Stay safe and be kind. Bye.
Bye.